They're totally harmless, see?
Oh my god!
Here you go. The intrepid reporter for Today News. Hi, my name is Carl Baptista. I am a maggot farmer. So actually we breed flies in the laboratory. The flies lay eggs which then turn into maggots. And these maggots are supplied sterile, disinfected, medical grade to hospitals for the debridement of chronic wounds. No, this is Lucilia cuprina. They're a tropical blowfly species predominantly. We collect the flies from the wild. In fact, just around the corner from our laboratory, what we do is we place slivers of rotting meat outdoors and hundreds of flies will come. So the busiest time in the is in the morning in the laboratories. We need to prepare the meat for the egg laying of the females. Then the slivers of meat are placed directly into the cages to encourage the females to start their egg laying. Maggot therapy is not as widely accepted in Singapore at the moment. I believe in time that acceptance will increase. And the main reason why the acceptance is low is predominantly because of the yuck factor. Most of the patients who have started maggot therapy, the feedback they usually give us is it's a lot better than I expected it to be. I expected it to be quite gory, but actually turned out to be, quite a painless exercise.
First, I thought maybe frightened. Yeah, if you put the maggot in, maybe I don't know whether I got pain or anything. But when I put down, I feel like no pain at all. But what I feel that time, they eat, they bite, just a bit of pain like an ant biting you. That's all.
Okay, so this is the size of the maggots going into the wound. Now the maggots will grow about 20 to 30 times in size. This is the size they are coming out. So maggots are supplied fresh after each order from a clinician. So if they order today, we supply them fresh tomorrow. Each vial that we supply to the hospitals contains 200 to 250 live, first instar larvae. And normally each patient will use on average between 2 to 4 vials. So maggots are never reused. After they've been placed on the patient, they're removed immediately for disposal. MDT is one of the oldest forms of medicine. It has been used for millennia. In fact, if you go and watch Gladiator, they actually put maggots into his wound. Now, to be a maggot farmer, you obviously need to understand your insect very, very well. But what does it really take to be a maggot farmer? Patience and dedication. And if you've got enough of these two, you could be quite successful in generating an insect product for use in hospitals.